What it do, YouTube, and welcome to the AOVI Clan Channel. What's up, guys? This is Nessinator1, and I'm going to be your gameplay commentator for this one, giving you guys a little bit of knowledge and at the same time giving you guys something to think about in Call of Duty Ghosts. But let me introduce the gameplay clip that you're about to watch. Obviously, it's Valid Shots. This guy has given us chemstrike after chemstrike after chemstrike, day after day after day. He's already uploaded on the channel a Domination chemstrike, an Infected chemstrike, a TDM, Flawless chemstrike, and this one here is on Blitz. Now, this is a special video, though. Before I go more into what's going on with Valid, this is a special gameplay in the sense that it's not just one chemstrike that gets dropped during the course of this game. It's actually three. Three by three different players, all in the same team. Valid was not running with anybody else from AOVI. He had a few friends rolling with him, but Valid's able to drop his chemstrike right here in the first half of the game. You're going to go ahead and love this first half of this gameplay clip. I'm going to tell you, Valid goes off on his FAD like he usually does, his favorite assault rifle in the game, just in case you were curious. There it is. And then he picks up a Bison and really goes ham on the guys, just putting it down, getting his chemstrike in the first half. And then in the second half of this game, two of his teammates both get chemstrikes towards the end of the game. So that's three total chemstrikes that are dropped during the course of this game. Obviously, the guys start rage quitting, people quit out, and at the end of it, you'll see nobody's even left on the other team. But nonetheless, I'd probably leave too if guys are dropping chemstrike after chemstrike after chemstrike on me. And it's just a great gameplay, great video. I thought it was fun to put up because how often do you see three separate players getting chemstrikes all in the same game? So there it is. Here it comes, and I hope you guys enjoy it. But that kind of gets me into, you know, my whole Call of Duty talk. You know me, you guys, the intros, and then from there, we'll talk a little bit about the game and what you guys think, a little bit of what I think and what the clan kind of feels about certain things, and, you know, see if we can get us a good little discussion going. But if not, hey, at least it's food for thought. So what we're going to talk about today is jump shot versus drop shot, or jump shotting versus drop shotting. What do you guys prefer to do? I mean, some people, you know, they're heavy on the jump shot, and some people love to drop shot. You know, you get the guys, that's all they like to do is drop shot, drop shot, drop shot. And then you get the guys that have the equal, you know, balance between the two, where they like to drop shot and they like to jump shot. And they can find a good, you know, balance of when they need to do which and when the perfect time for each one is. Because let's face it, I mean, sometimes that stuff can get you in trouble. Sometimes you can jump shot yourself into some trouble. And sometimes a drop shot could throw off your aim or put you in a predicament where you're not being very mobile. And then, you know, if you actually would have stood on your feet or stood crouched, you could have actually picked the guy off. But maybe he strafed you too fast and the drop shot kind of like, you know, put you in a pickle. So, nonetheless, you still have to have skill on when it, you know, what it takes when it chases these guys. Well, Duck Hunt right there. And this guy, I mean, come on. Come at me, bro. Seriously, come at me. And, you know, what and when is it the right time to do either? I mean, if you guys have maybe a preference of, like, you know, I do this more often when, you know, I'm more of a drop shotter and I'm more of a jump shotter. Like, me, personally, I didn't do any of that when I first started playing Call of Duty. When I first started playing Call of Duty, I guess you could call me a flat-footed player. I was always just, go ahead and, I was more of a strafer, I guess. I like to strafe, you know, and hit fire and all that good stuff. And then when I started playing Black Ops 2, I started watching the pros play. I started really taking into the whole YouTube competitive scene, watching nade shot videos and scumpy videos, and just really seeing how they maneuvered around the map and how they were just staying mobile and what they did. And it introduced me pretty much to the jump shot. And I was like, you know what, I don't have a scuff controller, let me try it out. And I still, to this day, do not have a scuff controller, but I love to jump shot. Jump shotting is something that I do quite often now. A lot of people bitch and they, oh, you jump shot, you think you're pro. You'd be surprised how many gun battles that you win because you pick the perfect time to jump shot. Now, I'm not saying it's the best thing to do every single time you're in a gunfight. I mean, there's times that you see people do it and you're like, you didn't need to do that. And then you just shoot them out of the air and their limp body just, you know, falls out of the air. It's pretty funny. But, you know, there's sometimes when you turn around a corner or if you're getting engaged with someone that has, bad aim or something like that. Obviously, you don't know that, but sometimes that jump shot can save you, especially when you can keep your shots on the person. And right here, I think when Valid drops these two dudes and he gets his chemstrike, which is the first one in the game, but not the last, like I said. Anyway, so, you know, I picked that up, I would say, around Black Ops 2. Now, with Ghost, you know, I would say the jump shot is still very effective, but maybe not as effective as the drop shot. I've been noticing a lot of people drop shotting these days. Some people, you know, they have mods to do stuff like that. I don't have a modded controller. I never had anything modded or anything of those type of toys in my repertoire. But you know, when it comes to drop shotting, I was just maybe not too much. Now, I heard people that do drop shot like to change their configuration of their buttons on their controller to tactical, because then you just click on that right toggle, hold it down, and it's easier to drop shot. I'm more used to the default. I don't know. I've always been, you know, I never really changed my controls ever since I started playing this back in, you know, the Black Ops 1 days and all that stuff. I never really, you know, used tactical. Was always a default player. I'm used to my right toggle being my stat button. And I actually tried it out, though, I would say about a week ago. And yes, it does help you with your drop shot. So for those of you guys out there that are curious about, you know, trying to get better with the drop shot, if you do use the tactical button layout for your controller, it does help with drop shotting. When it comes to jump shotting, it's just something, you know, if you have a scuff, obviously if you have a scuff controller, it's an easier world on both ends for doing both of those. I probably will not get a scuff controller till I get the Xbox One. I figured, why buy a scuff controller for the Xbox 360, seeing as though the 360 is going to run its course by the end of this summer, and we're all switching over to the Xbox One when the new title drops in November. So I probably will be buying a scuff controller for the Xbox One. But when I do, you know, obviously I'll be using that to my advantage to be more effective in drop shotting and jump shotting. And it does give you an advantage. It's something that does help you with your game. And, you know, if you have never tried it, you should try it. But I'm curious to know what you guys think. Which is more effective and which do you like to do more, and which have you had more luck with, I guess you can say. So that kind of gives me a little bit of what I wanted to go into. Now to kind of close it out with a little bit about the clan itself. We're doing good. We're doing the recruitments. I think we're up to about 25 players now. We got 5 more spots of availability, and then we'll cap out at 30. Keep it there for a while. See how it goes for the next couple of months, and then we may add more, or we may stay around that size till we, you know, like I said, move over to the Xbox One with the next Call of Duty title hits. And that's the last thing I kind of wanted to cover a little bit, which was, you know, the Call of Duty thing, the new trailer, it hit. I went over a little bit in my last video. I didn't really go into it too much, but I was just wanting to kind of touch on that again a little and ask you guys, you know, a lot of people out there are complaining that it's getting away from Call of Duty, or at least the feel of it, the way it looked, was a little bit too futuristic. Some people said, oh, it's like Crysis, it's like Titanfall, it's too much like Halo. Whatever the case may be, we really can't make those assumptions yet until we play it, until we have the game in our hands and we're able to put some hours into it. I mean, by the looks of the first trailer, which obviously a lot of it had to do with the campaign and stuff like that, there was no gameplay involved in there, no multiplayer gameplay involved, so who knows what's going on. I'm never quick to judge a game by its first trailer or anything like that. You know, we'll see what happens and we'll see how, you know, it all plays out. And hopefully it stays true to its Call of Duty nature and still feels like a Call of Duty game. But if it has elements of other games in it, it does feel a little bit of a Halo, maybe with the jump and the, like, look like it had jetpacks and they can jump further. Yeah, I think that's something that, you know, we'll be fine to adjust to. But again, we just hope it still feels like Call of Duty. I think that's all we all can wish for. Of course, there's going to be the haters out there that don't like Call of Duty, but that's fine. We're not part of that bunch. So anyway, here's the third chem strike, guys. Like I said, there was 3 chem strikes. Sorry for not calling out the second one, but I'm pretty sure you guys saw it. So 3 chem strikes, 1 game, pretty ridiculous, game of Blitz, and that'll end it out. You guys, thanks for all your views, subscribes, and likes. This is your boy, Nestinator1, saying I'm out.
Good job. Report to command for debrief.